It's easy to get started with Spring Boot Admin, and in this video, I'll show you how to get up and running in no time. If you follow along, you'll learn how to create a Spring Boot Admin server, how to register a client, and how to deploy the server to a lightweight version of the Tanzu application platform, one that doesn't have its own GUI. You begin by creating a Spring application using start.spring.io. From there, you can create a new Spring project and add the dependencies that you'll need. They are Spring Web, Spring Boot Actuators, Spring Dev Tools, Spring Security, and of course, Spring Boot Admin Server and Spring Boot Admin Client. Give the application a meaningful artifact ID and check the rest of the settings make sense before clicking the Generate button to download your project. Extract the zip archive to your file system and open it inside your IDE. I'm using Visual Studio Code in this example, but you could use Eclipse or IntelliJ. Setting up Spring Boot Admin requires very little code. Just add the @enableAdminServer annotation to your main Spring application class and resolve any missing imports. Here I'm adding a security configuration so that my Spring Boot Admin dashboard can be accessed without a username and a password. You can further customize your Spring Boot Admin application using an application.properties file. In these properties, you should set the application name and expose all the Spring Boot actuator endpoints. Exposing all the actuators is important. Spring Boot Admin reads the information from the actuators and presents the data in a friendly web-based user interface. Spring Boot Admin has two logical parts, a server and a client. Clients register with the server. In the properties file, you can tell the Spring Boot Admin server to register as a client of itself. You do this by setting the Spring Boot Admin Client URL property to localhost :8080. Once configured, the server should be ready to test. Open a terminal and start the application in the usual way. You can see the Spring Boot Admin dashboard by entering the URL localhost :8080 into your web browser. In the dashboard, you will see your first registered application, the Spring Boot Admin server. Because running in the cloud often demands different settings, you can add additional Spring profiles to customize the server for each environment you'll run it in. In this case, I'm going to run the server on the Tanzu application platform, or TAP for short. To create my TAP profile, I add another text file to the resources folder with the name application-tap.properties. These properties will be activated whenever the TAP profile is activated. In the TAP profile, I'll add three properties. They simply reconfigure the server to work nicely on my local TAP environment. Running the application on Tanzu application platform is super easy. The platform works in tandem with my source control system. It will check out the code, build it and run it in the cloud for me. As this is a new project, I need to add Git source control tracking. To do this, I'll initialize the project with Git, add all the code to version control, and create the first commit. I then push the code to a new remote repository on GitHub. I'm using the GitHub command line tool to do this. Finally, I'll use the Tanzu CLI to run the Spring Boot Admin workload on TAP. Notice how I'm adding the Spring Profile Active environment variable and setting it to TAP. This will activate my special TAP profile. The Tanzu application platform will now take the source code, build it into a container, and run that container on Kubernetes for me. And notice there's absolutely no YAML with this method. Once the application has finished deploying, you can obtain its URL using the get command. Open this URL in your browser. The Spring Boot Admin Server dashboard is now ready to help me examine and troubleshoot my application setup. I can register all my Spring Boot applications with Spring Boot Admin, and hopefully I'll never again struggle to remember all the application configuration details that I've set. Spring Boot Admin also shows me which applications are registered, their current health, their environment details, some basic metrics, and their configuration settings. It can even message me on Slack if any of my applications go offline for any reason. I hope you enjoy using Spring Boot Admin as much as I do, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Please let us know in the comments below what you thought, and of course, don't forget to like and subscribe so that you'll be notified whenever new Tanzu content becomes available.